Today I have the pleasure to introduce to you the very famous and very popular Swiss drummer Mathias Künzli. Mathias Künzli, nice. Thanks very much for having us.
Absolutely, my pleasure.
We're here in Brooklyn in your studio apartment. And you actually moved here after graduating from Berklee College of Music in Boston in 1998. And I was wondering, what was it that made you stay in the US and especially here in New York?
It was definitely the I got a good taste of international, you know, internationality, really. Like people from, as soon as I moved to Boston, I started hanging out with people from all over the globe, and just all their musical influences and cultural influences and different languages that collided up in Boston when I went to school was sort of the spark of like, wow, that's, there's a bigger world out there, you know. And it's not like Switzerland isn't international. Obviously we have a lot of different influences. Even growing up, I would grow up with people from, you know, all kinds of different places, Italy and former Yugoslavia and so on and so forth. But it just felt like it was more vibrant, you know, of a community. And especially in New York, I mean, is its own animal, you know. It doesn't compare to Boston at all. Boston is sort of a sleeping pill compared to this city. And I just had been coming down here a lot while I was in school. Whenever I had a longer break, I would, you know, come down here and get a taste. And it's kind of like a drug, you know. You just want to be around it. It kind of sucked me in, and I just wanted to try it out. I was kind of scared moving, not gonna lie. I was definitely very, had a lot of respect, and finally did it though, and it, you know, worked. It worked out.
Yeah. What would you say are the major differences being a professional musician working here in the U.S. and Switzerland?
Here you really have to be, you have to stay on it, or else somebody else is just going to do your job. You know, it's really, you're being replaced really quickly. And that's bad and sad in a way. On the other hand, it gives the creative scene a certain push that nothing has ever come out, nothing super creative or new or groundbreaking has ever come out of a comfortable situation. Yeah. It doesn't work that way. It's always where things are like edgy, a little pushy, and they're tight, and somehow that what makes a revolution or a new product to come out. So I feel like New York is kind of that, you know, a lot of stuff happening and a lot of people trying to reinvent themselves constantly, and a lot of different worlds constantly working together, different scenes. But, you know, both worlds are presenting, like, you know, good things and positive things, and I've just chosen to stick around for another while. We'll see how it all pans out. I'm not saying that I will never want to buy a farmhouse back home and or at least move into one and be really, really relaxed and have my animals.
You also got some new stuff going on right now. You are currently touring with Regina Spektor. She's quite big at the moment. She's number 3 in the top 200 Billboard charts, number 1 of the alternative charts. So I wonder, how did you meet her and how did this cooperation evolve out of that?
Yeah, it was somehow through mutual friends. I mean, I was lucky to meet a guy who had told me that she was looking for a drummer, and he's a drummer friend of mine, and he kind of made me aware of it. I didn't even really know that. And then I reached out to a friend who had played with Regina for many, many years and said if he could maybe reach out to them and maybe suggest me as a potential, or at least give me a shot and give me, you know, schedule an audition. And that's what happened. I got a call from them and I went in to play, and I got a second shot about 8 days later, sort of like a callback audition, they call it. And that same evening I had an email saying, all right, let's talk tomorrow, let's talk turkey, you know. And that's what it was. It was all sort of happened sort of like really quickly, and then and about 10 days after that we had the first show.
Oh, so, nice.
Yeah, it all just kind of
The tour actually will be heading to Europe next pretty soon, and you'll be also playing in Switzerland at the Blue Balls Festival in Lucerne. You excited?
Yeah, very much so. Yeah, I'm trying to get as many guest list tickets as I can. I already warned them. I'm like, I want many. Look how many, like a lot of them. Yeah. And unfortunately it'll just be getting into Switzerland, playing the show and leaving right away. Oh. Which is going to feel a little bit a little bit weird, but hopefully I get to dip into the lake before the show and buy me a good amount of chocolate that I always do when I, you know, store it in my bag and bring it back. But yeah, I'm excited, definitely. Okay, yeah.
Maybe you want to tell us some other projects you're working on right now? Yeah,
there's always a lot going on. I mean, besides, you know, playing for Regina right now, which does take a good amount of time. Usually my life is composed of many, many different, you know, projects and bands. Some bands I'm really part of. Some things just kind of come in more freely and more sporadically, sort of more freelancy. And there's a bunch. One that I really love that I've been really involved with is a band called Total Trees. Hello. Here, on my chest. It's a band that I really like. And it's a fun band. We've released a second record. We're doing a bunch of touring in the States. We're hoping to get to Europe soon and just trying to work it all out. There's that. There's many other things. I play with a lot of people around town. I play a lot of. I play with this lady, Allison Barber. She's a beautiful singer. I play with this lady, Nina Violet, another really great singer. I play some Bulgarian folkloric music. I play lots of sort of weird crossover, worldly type of crazy music. There's a trio that I'm in called Rushanim that I like a lot. It's there's always new things happening. People are always starting new ideas and
great. Thanks very much, Mathias, for taking the time, and all the best for your project and for the tour.
You're running.